Welcome to Professor Matt, Electronics for Beginners. Let's talk about voltage, current, and resistance. Electricity is the movement of electrons. Electrons are charged particles. The movement of these charged particles can be harnessed to do work. Your light bulb, your mobile phone, your TV, your computer, all are harnessing the movement of the electrons in order to do work. They all are operate using the same basic power source, the movement of electrons. When we talk about electricity, there are three fundamental terms we need to understand: voltage, current, and resistance. Voltage is the difference in charge between two points. Current is the rate at which charges are flowing. Resistance is material's tendency to resist the flow of charges, also known as current. When we are describing these terms, a common analogy is a water tank. In the water tank analogy, water represents the charges. Water pressure represents the voltage. The control valve represents the resistance. Let's open the valve a little bit. Water starts to flow. According to our analogy, this moving water represents the moving electrons. Moving electron flow is named as an electric current. Let's open the valve furthermore. We are reducing the resistance. This allows to flow more electrons, a high current. Okay now, let's close the valve a little bit. The water is still moving, that means electrons are moving. We are increasing the resistance. It reduces the water flow, also known as electron flow. Increase of resistance causes decrease of current. Let's pay attention to the pressure. I am using the word voltage to the pressure. Forget about the valve or resistance now. If we increase the voltage, it causes an increase in the speed of water flow. The amount of water flow in a second is higher than earlier. That means increasing the voltage also increases the current. If we decrease the water pressure, it causes to decrease the speed of water flow. The amount of water flow in a second is lower than earlier. That means decreasing voltage also decreases the current. That's the water tank analogy for electricity. Water represents the electrons. Pressure represents the voltage. Control valve represents the resistance. And finally, the water flow represents the electric current. If we are closing the control valve, the water flow is decreased. In the same way, increasing the resistance causes to decrease the current. If we are opening the control valve, the water flow is increased. In the same way, decreasing the resistance causes to increase the current. Let's look into the pressure again. If we are increasing the water pressure, the water flow is increased. In the same way, increasing the voltage causes to increase the current. If we reduce the water pressure, the water flow is decreased. In the same way, decreasing the voltage causes to decrease the current. Current is the rate at which charge is flowing. Current is measured in amperes. An ampere is defined as 1 coulomb of electrons per second passing through a point in a circuit. Voltage is the difference in charge between two points. Voltage is measured in volts. Voltage is represented in equations and schematic by the letter V. Voltage is the pressure from an electrical circuit's power source that pushes charged electrons through a conducting loop, enabling them to do work. Resistance is a measure of the opposition to current flow in an electrical circuit. Resistance is measured in ohms. symbolized by the Greek letter omega. All materials resist current flow to some degrees. They fall into one of the two broad categories, conductors and insulators.